Hi, I'm Pastor Reggie Clemens. Welcome to First United Methodist Church, Pearland. We are a church that believes God is real, and that's why we believe in following Jesus, building real relationships, growing in real discipleship, and experiencing real transformation. I am so glad that you are here to worship with us today online, and I hope that you know that I wish you were sitting right here with us. Trust me, we're going to be singing today. You will hear a word inspired by God, and I truly trust that you will take this word and go out into the world and let the world know that God is real. We truly enjoy and welcome your presence here today. Let's worship together. Thank you. Good morning. Well, let me get everybody else now. Good morning. Man, you really put some effort into that one. Let me tell you, that was good. Hey, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Pastor Reggie. I'm so glad that you're here this morning to join us in worship. We've been praying about this moment that you would be here. And again, we're just thankful that everyone is joining us this morning. And I want to begin by just letting you know that typically, I would not be the person that you would see standing here in this time. It would typically be our director of traditional music, Austin Rabin. Austin was on his way to work this morning, and someone ran into him. But he's doing fine. He said he's great. The car maybe not so great. But anyway, keep Austin in your prayers as he negotiates and navigates this or whatever. But again, he's doing great. So with him not being here, you get me. Amen. So I'm so thankful this morning. So let's go to God in prayer. We do thank you, Heavenly Father, for this time that we are here. We thank you and we lift up right now Austin and all that he has to deal with. But God, thank you for keeping him safe this morning. And God, as we go into this time of worship today, allow it to truly be pleasing to your ears. Everything we do, everything we say, everything we sing, allow it to truly be a joyful noise. In the holy and precious name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. I'm going to invite you, if you're able, stand with us as we sing our first hymn, Nothing But the Blood. It's actually hymn number 362 in your hymnal. We're going to sing verses 1 through 3. Thank you. You may be seated.
Good morning. Well, then can I get an amen too? Amen. All right. Sorry. Good morning. I'm Chris Coward. I'm your worship host today. And thank you for joining us for worship. If you are here this morning, you should have received a printed bulletin or connection guide. And you can fill out this form and attach it. The form attached and drop it in the offering tray or the offering box in the narthex. Or you can register your attendance with us by using your cell phone to text the word HERE to 281-485-1466. If you are new to this worshiping community, we would love to connect with you. You can find the connection information in the printed bulletin, or you can swing by the information desk at the Narthex after service, and one of our amazing volunteers would love to connect with you and give you a gift of appreciation for choosing to worship with us today. For those of you who are joining us online, we invite you to check out our online bulletin at fumcpearland.org/bulletin. You can register your attendance by clicking on the check in here button. Clucking doesn't work as well on that website. Also, we would like to have an announcement that we are now starting the Real Talk podcast. For those of y'all who are not informed, I'm letting y'all know, we have a podcast which began airing on Wednesday, February 21st. Real Talk is a podcast with an increased intentionality of having honest conversations about faith, church, and the real conflicts and controversies that surround the complicated reality of real people living in faith today. That's a lot of words with no comma. There, well, I should have. We hope to invite those who are curious, cautious, and considering faith into deeper conversations with those who don't always agree, revealing the work of Jesus Christ among us all. We are proud to announce that to help us pay production costs of these podcasts, we have applied for and received a grant from the Texas Annual Conference Innovation Lab in the amount of $5,000. Yay! We will also be blessed to have Bishop Harvey as our guest on our podcast airing Wednesday, March 6th. To listen to our podcast, go to our website, fumcpearland.org. We are so glad you are here today as we welcome Bishop Cynthia Harvey to bless us with a message we know will inspire us and encourage us. The mission of this church that we embrace is that we endeavor to follow Jesus, build real relationships, grow in real discipleship, and experience real transformation. We believe we should all strive to do this to become the church we should be. Have a wonderful morning. I would like now to invite Pastor Thea to lead us in our statement of faith.
Welcome once again to First United Methodist Church Pearland and this worship service. I'm Pastor Thea, and it's always a joy and a pleasure to spend this time with you. If you are willing and able, would you stand for our affirmation of faith? In this time, as we are preparing for Easter, our hearts and minds and souls for resurrection, we have a special Lenten affirmation, and those words are on the screen that you can follow along with. I believe God the Creator, who made me and all things, who set me on my path in this world. I believe in God the Savior, who is one with the Creator, who rescued me, all creation, from the depredations of our violations against God and creation. This man, Jesus of Nazareth, the Christ, walked a path through this world, taking on human form, having been born of a woman through the power of the Holy Spirit. He lived and worked in this world among people just like me. He walked God's path to death on a cross and rose from the dead to open our pathway to eternal life. I believe in God, the Holy Spirit, my counselor and guide, who is one with the Creator and the Christ, who through the body and blood of Jesus brings me into communion, all people, past, present, and future, who calls me to walk a sacred way of life through this world, caring for creation and the people I meet on the way, loving them, helping them, welcoming them without prejudice, being God's hands and feet in the world. Amen. You may be seated. And would you join me now in an opening prayer? Good, loving, and powerful God, we are preparing our hearts, our minds, our souls, and our body for resurrection, for redemption, for the renewal that only you can bring. As we continue to journey toward the resurrection of Jesus Christ, we continue to die to our sins, to our shame, to all the ways we think we're not yet ready, and all the ways we know we already are. Oh, gracious God, we continue to come, to humble ourselves before you, and strive to follow where you truly lead, trusting it must be new life, even for me. And yet I am not alone on this journey. No, O holy God, you have given us the church, your body in each one of us. And that is why we have gathered together today on one accord with trust and desire to seek you, to see you, and even dare to believe we are worthy enough to reflect you in our world today. And it is this union, communion only made possible through you, O gracious God, that draws us together and gives us the power and courage to pray these words together that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Hi, my name is Lincoln, and I don't know how to skateboard, but I can learn how to skateboard. Just like we come to church and school, come to our sermon session and learn how to learn about God, and come to sermon session because it's really fun.
Good morning and welcome. I'm Shannon Garza, Director of Pearland Kids, and on behalf of our family ministries, I want to welcome you. I have my friend here, Lincoln, with me today.
Hi.
And we would like to invite all of our K through fourth grade friends to come join us in sermon session. Right now, our series is called How To, and we are learning how to make a difference, how to share with others, how to love our enemies, and how to pray. And parents, your children will be returned to you at the end of service. If you would like any more information or to check out all of our events, I would welcome you to visit our website, and I hope you enjoy your service. Bye.
Bye. Well, good morning, church. So our generosity is a spiritual matter. It is part of our discipleship journey. As we know that our support allows us to grow spiritually as we accomplish our mission. We have a video from Robert and Aaron Steele to talk just about what and why generosity matters to them. Take a look.
Hello, I'm Robert Steele, and this is my wife, Erin. We've been members of this church since 1988. I have a long-standing history with the Methodist Church. Both my grandmothers were Methodist. We were married at St. Stephen's United Methodist Church in 1980. My wife and I attend the traditional early service. We are members of the New Life Sunday School class. The New Life has a great team of teachers that take turns leading us in interesting Bible studies. We also have weekly emails and social events that keep us connected.
I'm a member of the Intercessory Prayer Group that meets on Tuesdays. So when you fill out a tear-off card from your bulletin, we pray aloud for these requests. If you fill out the card, we pray silently for these requests and sign the card and mail it, and then we follow up regularly with those on the prayer list. And it's a really great ministry at our church, and I'm blessed to be a part of it. Also, I wanted to tell a story that impacted my giving. When I was in high school, I took an elective consumer math class, and we had a guest speaker who was the vice president of Northwest Bank. His wife had been my fourth grade Sunday school teacher. Red Combs said in his speech that the first check he and his wife wrote each month was to the church, which happened to be my church. And I always remembered that, and even though we don't write checks now, a donation comes out of our bank account at the same date every month to First United Methodist Church Pearland to support all the programs. Our grandkids went to MCP here. My daughter's a Methodist children's program teacher, and so is my niece. My great nephews and my great nieces attend that program and learn about the Bible and Jesus. And the church is God's house. We need electricity. We need a good roof. We need comfortable spaces for worship, for classes and events. And people paid for those things when we were visiting and members of these other churches that we mentioned.
We have a wonderful pastor, staff, and members. The message to love God and each other while bringing others to Christ is why we worship here. We will continue to financially support the First United Methodist Church Pearland and all its important programs.
Thank you to Robert and Aaron for that great testimony. And also on a side note, thank you to Mr. Combs, wherever he may be, and all the Mr. Combs that teach young children those things. We can not say enough to everyone for how much your generosity blesses us and everyone that we are able to minister to. It allows our church to do things that we do and to live out our mission. We want to invite you and everyone into this aspect of generosity. Your financial support is important to this church, but it is more important in supporting of God and His kingdom. Right now, I would invite you to give online. If you would, you can take a picture of the QR code in your bulletin, or you can text the word GIVE to 281-485-1466. You can also place your offering in the offering plates as they come by in just a moment. Our ability to do great things in ministry depends on you. Will the ushers please come forward? Please pray with me. God, we come here and we thank you for the amazing gifts and blessings that you've poured out upon us. As an act of worship to you, we come and give back just a small part of that to you. Take it, multiply it, may it be used to glorify you in all that we do with it. In your name, amen.
Well, good morning and again, everyone. I have the pleasure of introducing a very dear friend and our bishop, the bishop of the Texas Annual Conference, Bishop Cynthia Harvey. And I'm just thankful. We've been looking forward to this day, and I just wanted to share with you just briefly just how we got here after having had conversation, because I want you to know that this is a busy lady. She does a lot of traveling. I mean, I was actually in Nashville with her this past week for a few days, but that's just like a part of what she does. She is busier than anybody I know. So in order to get her here, it did not come without work. Amen. I had to basically try to get on her calendar, and then I had to listen to her tell me no several times that she was not coming, and I had to offer money. I had to basically say I would feed her and whatever. And then I just finally did the smart thing. I basically just reached out and contacted her husband, Dean, and he got it set up for me. Amen. Thank you, Dean. No, that's Dean. We thank you. Thank you for being here today. I'm really thankful. And again, I could go into all kinds of accolades about who she is. I'll let you look that up on your own. Let me just share this with you. One of the great joys that I think we had, particularly in terms of everything that happened to us, was when we actually found out that she was going to be the bishop that was actually coming to the Texas Annual Conference. There was a lot of joy that day, amen, because we truly welcomed her back home to her conference. So I am thankful that she did agree to come back here to speak to us today, and I'm going to allow her, if she were to come to you in her own way. I would love for you to give her a Pearland First United Methodist Church welcome to Bishop Cynthia Fierro Harvey.
None of what he said is true. I'm not going to say liar, liar, pants on fire or anything like that, but no, he did not have to convince me. I said yes, and I with you to celebrate this day. And I will just say, I know you know how great your pastors are, but they are amazing. And I have spent the week with your senior pastor, with Reggie, at GCFA this week. And he does an amazing job leading the church, the general church, in that way. Extraordinary. And everybody knows it. Makes me a little nervous when other people find out how great he really is. But he does an amazing job, and I celebrate you and all of you as well. Dean and I have been looking forward to being with you today, and you know, I don't know how many times you come to church and the scriptures from Lamentations. Most people don't really know exactly where it is. It's a small book buried in the Old Testament. So hear these words, and I left my glasses in the office. I'm going to try. The steadfast love of the Lord endures forever. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I hope in him. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. And because I know your pastor, and I know that this is a singing church, I'm going to put you on the spot, Mary Catherine. Can we sing that refrain of great is thy faithfulness one more time? Can we do that? Can we do it? All right. Now, I want you to be the choir as well this time. All right. I want you to hear these words. Just the refrain. Just the last little part. All right. Okay. They're going to lead you. Why don't you stand up too? You're the choir.
Thank you.
may be seated. When you come to a singing church, you just got to keep singing. Great is thy faithfulness is really one of my favorite hymns. It's what I would call my anthem, if you will. My theme song over these past several years. It's been playing in my head and mostly in my heart. Now, the other song is Alicia Keys, This Girl Is On Fire. But we're gonna stick to the hymn. It's a little more churchy on a Sunday morning. But if you've been following me now these last few weeks, you know that I've been traveling the conference singing this song. See, great is thy faithfulness is what I hear and what I experience when I'm in churches with people like you. I cannot even begin to imagine what you have been through. But I can imagine that it is the faithfulness of God, the faithfulness of God that has sustained you. People attempted to tear you apart. And look at you now. Look at you now. It hasn't been easy, and you may feel a bit frayed around the edges, but from what I see right here, from my viewpoint, from here I see resilience and an unmatched, undeterred spirit. I see strength and I see courage and a renewed boldness to face the future unafraid. You've been patiently faithful. You know that morning does come. You know that there is a new day dawning. You know that good things come to those who wait and who wait faithfully and patiently. You know that God is great and God's steadfast love endures forever. Not just for today or for tomorrow or for next week or next year, but forever. Y'all, forever is a really long time. And as we travel the season of Lent, we're reminded of the importance of spending time in reflection in order to fully grasp the meaning of these words. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand has provided. God is faithful and loves us so much that he would sacrifice his beloved son. Friends, that's a level of faithful that's virtually impossible for us mere mortals to grasp. And as a good infomercial says, and there's more, God provides our every need. All you have needed, God has provided. Not just some, but all you have needed, God has provided. God takes the impossible and makes it possible. And just think about a few things that have happened just for a minute over these last few years. I'm not going to stay here long because I'm boldly squared toward the future, but I think it's important that we look back and see what has actually been happening in our lives as we prepare this sacred moment to move forward. Just take a quick look back. Who would have imagined a worldwide pandemic? Virtual church, whoever put those two words together before 2020? Who would have thought that mask wearing would become our daily bread and vaccines and boosters and wars and mass shootings, oh my gosh, have become our daily occurrence? There were 655 mass shootings in 2023. And there have been 58 so far in 2024, 55 days into the new year. I checked last night to make sure that was still the right number, and it had actually increased from what I had a few days before. There's been amazing and continues to be political turmoil across the world. Racism is rampant in our communities. Persons of color are being killed at an alarming rate. Anti-Semitism is on the rise. Mental and spiritual health challenges are unparalleled. Over half of the churches in the Texas Conference disaffiliated, and about that many clergy withdrew, and you, many of you know some of them. I'm sure that I've left something out. And any one of these things would have been enough. Yet you and I know God's faithfulness is great. Morning by morning, new mercies we do see, and all we need, God's hand has provided. Great is God's faithfulness unto us. Y'all, we don't deserve this. God is faithful unto us. You have everything you need, and then some. Now, I know what you want to say, but Bishop Harvey, you know, the ledger isn't adding up, and stuff continues to happen every day. Let me say it again. You have everything you need right here, right here, right now, today. God sustains us when things seem impossible, when we don't know what to do, when we've forgotten more than we know. We have everything that we need. New mercies we see, and God's abundant love for us. We have strength for today, bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings are ours, 10,000 beside. In the midst of chaos, some we can't control, and frankly, some we've created ourselves. In the midst of it, God is at work. Great is God's faithfulness. You know, in these in-between times when what's in front of us looks like nothing that's behind us, we learn each and every day that there is, in fact, bright hope for today. Strength for today, bright hope for tomorrow. When we're losing strength and hope isn't so bright, you know what we do? We borrow it. We borrow it from one another. We become strength and hope for another. You are modeling today what it looks like to borrow strength and hope from one another. Even and especially in this extraordinary time when people we love have chosen to leave the church that we love, families are torn apart, I'm strengthened still by what God is doing in and among people like you. You know, leadership gurus say that at times like this, we have a couple of options. It's that fight or flee thing. We can see things this season as a problem to be solved, or we can see it as an opportunity to do something new. You have great leaders in this church. Clergy leaders, lay leaders, young leaders, old leaders, because you are a church that understands the importance of taking that next faithful step. Next faithful step. You are leading in extraordinary ways. You are seizing this moment. You've chosen to do a new thing, to be a renewed people, to be faithful to what God is asking of you. You've chosen to sing an old song with a renewed sense of passion and of hope and of love and a new understanding of God's great faithfulness. You see, today, what you could not see a few months ago or maybe even yesterday, you're experiencing firsthand the surprises of the Spirit at every turn. Great is God's faithfulness. So First United Methodist Church of Pearland, I have two words for you today. If you remember nothing else I have said today, I want you to remember these two words. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for reclaiming your identity, your place in this community. Thank you for being the church. Thank you for your undeterred and resolute spirit. thank you for your commitment to reimagine a spirit of Methodism in this community that has not yet been seen or heard. It's so exciting to see how you are recapturing that spirit of movement, of the movement of God, and how you're doing that together. You've created this place, this sacred place, not where minds agree, but where hearts agree, where the spirit of the movement of God is truly and boldly renewed. What you're doing day in and day out is nothing short of courageous. God is faithful. And with faithful followers of Jesus like you, I'm certain that our best days are ahead. Did you hear that again? Our best days are ahead. So keep listening for those deepest yearnings of the people around you right here in Pearland and beyond. And friends, it's okay not to have all the answers. It's okay not to have it all figured out. By the power of the Holy Spirit, God will continue to work in this great church and lead you to a new future that's filled with hope and promise and new possibilities you haven't even thought of yet. You see, you have this amazing, wide open window to revive and renew and reinvigorate and reimagine a new future for First United Methodist Church Pearland and this entire community, a future that's filled with this birth, rebirth, a renewed sense of unity in this church, in this conference, and in the United Methodist Church. And friends, I pray that you will continue to set a table that's large enough for everyone, leaving room for those with differing thoughts and differing opinions and differing interpretations. You see, at God's table, there is no hierarchy. It's a beautiful metaphor for what it means to be the church, to be that table where there is no hierarchy. We come as equals to this table, no matter who you are, where you come from, or how you come, whether you're rich or poor or black or white or brown or Asian, whether you have it all together or whether you're broken to pieces or whether you're still trying to figure it out. This table of grace is set for everyone. This table, your table is a table of grace that's set for everyone. So I celebrate that you're using your energy to make something of this moment, something that's holy and sacred and a catalyst for change. I say this every chance I get, everywhere I go. When you base every decision you make on love, you will never go wrong. When you base every decision you make on love, you will never go wrong. We don't have to understand. We don't have to agree. We just have to be willing to love. So I pray that you'll continue to love one another, to embody what it means to be the church, and continue to sing of God's great faithfulness. Because I believe that with grit and determination and the guidance of the Holy Spirit, the people in this community are going to hear you singing. They're going to hear you singing. They're going to wonder, what in the world is going on down there at that United Methodist Church in Pearland? So keep singing. Thank you for being the church. Thank you for being faithful. Great is thy faithfulness. All you have needed, thy hand has provided. Keep singing. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Thank you very much. Bishop, we do thank you for your words, and we will keep singing, amen. I am so thankful to be here today. I know that there are folks that truly come here that have actually experiencing what we do, would want to talk to us about what it means to be a part of this community. We would love to have those conversations. We will be in the narthex. You can grab any of us and we'll take as much time as needed to talk to you about that. If you're online, you can text the word follow to 281-485-1466 and we'll spend as much time getting you connected as well. Our final hymn this morning will be hymn number 377, It Is Well With My Soul. I'm gonna ask if you're able to stand and join us as we sing verses 1 and 4.
Friends, as you go from this place, go sing in a song. Let this community know that there is something going on here. Yeah. Something's going on. So keep on singing and know that God is indeed faithful and has provided everything that you need. So go now in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thanks for joining us today. I truly hope you enjoyed your worship experience as much as we enjoyed having you join us. If you'd like more information about our church, go to our website, fumcpearland.org. You can find out more information about the wonderful things that are going on at this church in this worshiping community. We invite you to come back and join us at any time. In fact, one of the joys that I have with everyone, whether they're in person or online, is truly getting to know people. Feel free to reach out to me at any time. And you can always know this, I'll pray for you, you pray for me, and watch God change things. Amen. Be blessed.